After I died, they cut me open and looked inside.
Maybe I'm foolish, maybe I'm blind, thinking I can see through this and see what's behind.
Freeman is the latest project by Strictly Arts Theatre Company. It's been funded by the Arts Council England in its research and development process, and obviously we're hoping to extend it after that. William Freeman was a young man, born in Auburn, New York in the 1800s. You have this 16-year-old child who is accused of stealing a horse, a crime that he didn't commit. He gets sentenced to 5 years for it. He pleads his innocence in jail, and for that he's beaten. He's subject to these horrific beatings. He then comes out at 21 and kills the members of the Van Ness family. They create a monster, effectively.
Some people got the real problems. Some people out of love.
Freeman is about the persecution of black people with mental health problems in the prison system here and in America. There are six characters in the play, and every one of them is a real character from history, going back to 1840s, which is Daniel M'Naughton, which is our oldest character, right up to Sarah Reed, who died this year.
This is a very human story. This is about human beings. This is their stories. The piece is in development. It's new. It's going somewhere. It's being made up. So even as we speak now, we're not quite sure what's going to end up on the stage. But I think that we are interested in the themes and interested in the people and the characters and the stories that they have to tell.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Human after all, I'm only human after all.
Ultimately, this journey that William Freeman goes on, the process that he has, the injustices he faces, is because he's black. And so at the end of his journey, when he feels this rage, this anger, this hate, and commits this horrific crime because of the way he feels, we now have a term for that, and we call that now black rage, which was a term I never used to understand, and I never used to agree with it. It offended me. But when I began to understand it, and when people educated me on the term, I began to understand what it truly meant. I definitely understood it in the case of William Freeman.
Do what I can, don't put the blame on me. Don't put your blame on me.